now.
Oh no. And it gets tight.
I don't think it'll come off.
We can remove this bolt on this side and just rotate this.
No, you know, because it hits it. Why are they this long? Holy moly, what kind of bolt is this? Wait. Put these in here?
Yeah.
Are they factory?
They are, just not from this place. Well, they may be.
Why are they Torx? This is not the bolt that goes here.
Well, they're BMW bolts, they're just not from this place. That's for sure. Okay.
I got it.
I don't know why I didn't put any anti-seasoning.
Yeah, and I have some.
I think I cared. No, I always do. I don't know. This is just different.
Okay, so, and then somewhere down there. I don't know what else holds this thing.
Well, now the exhaust.
Yes, that plastic piece.
To remove that plastic.
Yeah. 10 feet long.
Well, that's factory, that's for sure. I think that's 14 or 15. About probably 16.
Oh, and this, of course, spins. That's why. Why would you do that?
Well, that's BMW.
But why? Like, why not put just an insert on the back? Like, freaking idiots. Whoever designed the 1 Series is an idiot.
Well, that's the problem. So this is a 15 millimeter. I don't think I have it.
A 15? Are those factory or do you put those?
No, I replaced like. I think I replaced 2 of them.
Mm.
With the bolt.
You didn't need a 15?
Yeah, 15.
That's a 15.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh. And also your tightening.
And it's copper. Oh, man.
Well, you tightened these.
I did. And I think I torqued them to proper spec. Wow. They're copper. Or not. I'm sure I installed them properly. And I think they're copper.
You need a breaker bar? Or a...
Oh, I don't know if I can break or strip that. That's not good at all.
How do you even get to those other ones?
You need like a socket extension. Well, but why?
Because you ugga-dugged them.
No, I used the anti-seize on them too. These are definitely...
Or a hammer?
Anti-seize.
Or a deep, or a 15, or a deep 15?
Yeah, and a breaker, but I don't look at them. Oh, that's because your socket is like weird, right?
Okay. Well, it's a bolt, right?
Yeah.
So if it snaps, it'll pop.
Yeah. So well, this one started.
I can go get a D15.
No, they're good.
What about the other two?
Well, that you just need an extension. Yeah.
No.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, it's a bolt. So. Yeah, it was fairly easy. I think I bought these like from FCP or something who sells, and they kind of looked.
Okay, so
do
you need something to push it out with?
This one's all good. This, see, I don't know what it is, but
can you put a regular bolt in here?
Well, it's kind of regular, it's like it's a regular bolt in a sense that kind of.
I put it on the ratchet.
Okay, so this turns. I have a feeling it will snap too. It's tight. Even if it tried to, do you have any fluid oil?
No, not really.
Yeah, I don't think we can reuse these.
No, probably not.
I have some copper knots. Did you buy any knots?
I should buy copper knots. Not bolts. I don't want to put back in. What are you calling them? Get some stainless.
I think these were stainless.
These?
Yeah. Just not the... not exactly the correct bolts.
Those are studs, huh? You want to try E46?
Yeah, it's exactly the same. I think we're on the size the same. But I don't think exhaust is ever going to tolerate this. You see? This undercut.
Yeah.
It's not a good thing to have.
Should be a full bolt.
And not that long either.
No.
So, extension, I guess.
Yeah. Long one?
Yeah.
Stubby. Have.
This might work.
Or longer. You have to remove that plate, those ones.
This?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, so let's see. Do a longer extension.
Let's see if this works. This can be a problem. I don't think this could be a problem because I already removed those ones at least.
Oh, those are the regular ones?
Yeah.
Well, they have to drill out. Yeah. You should use the ones or swivel.
I think it turned a little. They kind of looked okay that time, so I did not drill them out, and I should have.
So now we got two bolts and a broken stud.
And it is copper.
Yeah.
So it didn't really help a lot, like I don't know why they even bother. This is what I didn't want to. If we use like a torch on these nuts first, they might have had a chance. See, this one came off. So that's it.
And then what's on, I guess, the back or the middle here?
Looks like a pain in the butt.
Yeah.
And then hangers in the back.
Yeah, now move to the back.
So probably this one first.
Yeah. Are they not tight enough?
No, they're tight.
Are they tight? So I need a breaker box.
Well, no, this one's have anti-C, so you did that right.
Well. No, but tell me, did I ever have a reason to remove it?
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
Didn't you do the whole rear end in this?
Yeah, but that doesn't mean the drive shaft needed to be off.
No, how you it's connected to a diff.
Like you do now. You just get this thing off. Tight?
Yeah, max tight.
Max. They have to be actually tight in the breaker bar. They have one piece.
Yeah. Okay, the last one, I think you have to actually rotate it.
Yeah.
Mm. Have to probably put it in. Where's it?
Where's it worn out? In here, I guess? Why is she saying that it was worn out? Probably here.
No, but was it this the whole, oh, she said the rear end is making noises.
Alex said the joint was somewhere bad.
That's one joint.
Look at this. Why is the parking brake lines rusting? Like,
I think it's they chip out now on these.
Look, this. It's a car from 2008.
Yeah, shouldn't it even be close to having rust like that? But yeah, that's, there's no reason for this to rust. But this one, it's all, yeah. They don't care as much anymore. Cheap metals, low quality.
So we put it in neutral and then rotate?
I think so. No, you should be able. Make the ignition on, then press the brake and put it in neutral. Socket for this breaker bar.
How big?
Ah, oh, just a socket.
I mean a socket.
I mean 19 socket.
Oh, short, eh?
Short. Short is enough. I'm trying to remember how I did this without
19.
Without getting to, you know, to remove the brace. I don't want to remove this brace.
Oh, I have to remove the brace. You have to remove the brace, Charlie.
I don't think I did before. Let's see if this. Oh, did I say 19?
Yeah. Probably 18.
No. 18 is one side. And 19 the other side.
Are you removing it with the rubber or without the rubber?
With the rubber. Because that's the only way to do it without getting the. Because you're replacing this rubber thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Here's one. Now we go. Another 90. Yeah, even the transmission plug is rusty. Yeah, this car for some reason had always had so much rust. And I could not understand why.
Alright, if you hold that for a second, I'm gonna
Well, okay, I can.
Hold it there.
Yeah.
Let me get this one off.
Tight. Need a bigger breaker bar. Yeah.
Freaking way.
Did it?
Yeah, good.
Okay, I'm... Oh, it started.
Did it?
Yeah. I don't know if we should just rotate and do the other one and then go back with the ratchet. I'm sure if you had like a slightly better wrench, you could just easily do
this. How are we gonna tighten that thing again?
The same way? I'm not sure if they're actually, I think they're tight enough. Yep.
Transmission boys. Mm. Probably the right way to do it though.
And you only need this to torque them. You should buy these bolts too?
Mm-hmm. Wait, you passed it.
No?
No, that one.
This is actually making any noises or vibrates or what?
I don't know.
Like, why are we... Then this is.
Well, Christian, this bearing's probably dead. I don't know. And imagine you bought a 1M and you paid a lot of money and it's the same exact.
It's exactly the same everything.
Yeah. And it's same rust.
Rust wouldn't be fun.
I guess it's a 7.
Oh, these two. Yeah.
And it was like 13.
Yeah.
Oh, these are finger tight.
Well, they're not supposed to be like tight.
Okay. Is your part coming off?
Yeah, it's out.
Because this one does not want to go out.
Oh, that's because you have to. Transmission.
Yeah. Kind of dead.
I think it's. Okay, it's out. This is not
replaceable. And that one is.
It has a bit of a play. I wouldn't say it's like terrible. I mean, you may feel it, but.
This one isn't dead. Totally dead.
No, that looks okay. I'm kind of worried that I may not have
this one is cracked and stuff.
Preloaded my center bearing. See, that's the difference. This has a seal,
mm-hmm.
and this has some kind of a knot. I don't think I ever. So this covers the splines. That doesn't cover the splines. Not the best idea. And these U joints are, they look totally different. The snap rings, I guess you can
replace it.
Yeah, they replace those.
And you balance them, I guess.
That looks really, this doesn't look as neat as this.
Yeah, but this is $1,000.
It's a factory. I wonder if they just make those.
Probably.
Not like rebuilding, but just making new. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like 500.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's $1,000 here. I bought mine for $100 from UK. Used. I had to replace this. This looked okay, but I don't know how long it's going to last.
Yeah.
So.
All back together.
And we'll suck if I need to replace it.
Anti-seize on these.
This is Germany.
Yeah.
Nice.
SGF.
What brand?
SGF, I guess. Whatever that is.
I don't know what it is.
Same manufacturer as the one. So do we put anti-seize on these? Or
oh,
no?
It says BGF.
Or BGF.
A little bit, maybe. Just to. It's nice to have the arrows. In the sense that if this ever comes up, if this ever comes apart, you have these arrows that will allow you to line up the two pieces. And this one has a knot here, unlike the factory OEM that has a seal, rubber seal. Doesn't look terrible. And this replacement is made in the USA. Look at it this way. There. So this replacement drive shaft is half the price of the factory OEM. Is about $1,000 for 128 E82. Yeah, it's still buzzing.
The key now, everything is like no need for buzzing. I want to buzz. I wonder if you should go find these brackets.
Which brackets?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, well, like maybe $20. I had to buy.
You replaced them?
No, the manual has it.